If you're ready to have your apps get superpowered with more AI, look no further than this video. I'm going to be breaking down Softr's new AI assistant that is available directly in your apps and can analyze your data in real time. So if learning more about leveraging AI in your custom Softr apps is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Softr is one of those tools that we have been using for years to build custom front-end portals, specifically for external but also internal users to access and really just have that custom branded portal or workflow application that you always wanted. Now, before I get into the heart of this video, I do want to invite you to follow along with me. If you are not already a Softr customer, we have a free 1 month at the pro level in Softr that is available to you. If you follow the instructions that you're seeing on your screen right now, you can claim that value, and it's over $100 for this free month at pro. So be sure to use the referral code that you see, and we'll share that with this video. Now go ahead and open Softr up and follow along with us, and we are going to get started by using a template. This is the Studio Nova template. Now with Softr templates, we could always open up the preview and kind of poke around, but for us, I want to get right into the template. So let's roll right into it. We're going to install this in our space, and this is a project management style of a template. So we can see here on the left-hand side, not a whole lot has changed inside of Softr in terms of the settings. We still have our pages here on the left. One recent change, although it's not associated with AI, is that our interface, our data, and our users are all up here at the top. And in fact, for this particular template, you'll see that our database is actually in Softr. So you'll notice that earlier when we installed this template, we did not have to discuss or point Softr to where our data was stored, because in this case, the data is coming from Softr itself. We are using Softr as the data layer. And now it's time to get into the AI component. So right now, let's take a quick look at our first page here, the master project list. You'll see that we have a button in the upper right corner to add a record. So if we were to click into here and we looked at the action side, the add a record is a standard action button that we can include. And of course, we can label it whatever we like, and we give it the action of adding a record, right? Pretty standard stuff in terms of adding new buttons to an app. But we want to access AI inside of our data. And so what we want to do is, you know, bring this functionality into our app. So we can add a new button here. And again, bear in mind that I got here by going into my page block and moving over to the actions panel. Obviously, the first thing you see when I click on add top bar button, you see that Ask AI is currently in beta. That, my friend, is exactly what we're going to be installing here. And let's read the prompt just to make sure that there are no surprises. So it says, let your users ask questions about data in this block via an AI bot. All filters and user permissions applied to the data will be respected. This is really important. We don't want to ever install an AI that has access to the full data on the back end. And then when we share limited data with somebody, we don't want them to get answers about the full data set. Imagine that you are, for example, storing payroll data in an app. You would not want someone to go into that app and say, how much is this person getting paid? That's private information that frankly does not need to be shared with people who are not in HR or the payroll department. So, this is really important. Whenever you're using an AI bot, make sure that these permissions are going to apply, because we need to be sure that people cannot ask AI questions or receive answers, more importantly. They can't receive answers to questions that they should not be able to ask about data that they cannot see in the app. So this is really important, but most AIs have already thought about this when you're installing them in your no-code tools, but do make sure that this kind of thing, these permissions apply in whatever different AI tools you're using. Thankfully, in Softr, they've already thought of this, so we can move on past this point. Now, the other one that I want to bring up, and it doesn't necessarily say it here, but we are not needing to integrate our app with ChatGPT or build any kind of API into another AI tool. This is part of Softr. We are, yes, I mean, do note here, right? By enabling the feature, we do agree to send our data to a third-party AI model provider. Yes, it's third-party. We are agreeing to that. But we don't have to actually integrate it in any other way, other than bringing it into our app and accessing it and turning it on. Now, I'll be honest with you. We built an app in Gap Consulting that we sell called No Code Accelerator. And it's our course. We have tons of information. And one of the things that our users have been asking for months, if not longer, is a nice, easy place that they can go and, you know, ask questions about, like, take me to this particular example or take me to this specific course lesson. I don't want to have to click through 10 different places. I don't know where the exact lesson is in your course. Well, now you can talk to AI, and provided that you have access to the course and the course lessons, look at this. I mean, how cool is it that we can right here inside of our apps now give people the ability to engage with this content and the data in a more meaningful way? All right. The other thing to note is, of course, that the feature is in beta. This is kind of standard stuff, right? Usage limits may apply. They might limit how much we're allowed to ping it. But you can toggle this message off so that you don't see it again, or just keep it there and we're going to enable it. And just like that, you'll see that we added the new button, Ask AI. And here it is. If we were to, again, on the right-hand side of our Softr build, we see that we've got the button right here. We have messages. We have AI settings that we can configure. We have the suggested prompts and appearance. So let's dial into these a little bit. So we've got messages. We can change the symbol here, the icon for this button. We can change the way it shows up. I like Ask AI. I think that's great. Input placeholder, we could change this. We can change the welcome message, the error message, the limit hit message. We have a disclaimer about AI can make mistakes. So all of this is customizable in terms of how it shows up in your app. Let's look at the AI settings. Configure fields only or any fields from the source. So we can choose where the AI can choose value from. So when we choose whether the AI can use data from fields in the block or from any fields that exist in the mapped data source. Now again, remember, permissions apply. So the users can only ask questions and only get answers that are relevant to the stuff that they can see or the stuff they have access to. But what you see here, the note at the bottom, AI will never use data from records that a user cannot see. So just reiterating what I was mentioning. But we can say you can use fields that are connected to all of this data. So, you know, this data that we're looking at, the source is presumably some sort of project data, right? Studio Nova, the table is projects. So we're looking at project data. We can, obviously, projects are going to be connected to a lot of stuff. Maybe they're connected to tasks. Maybe they're connected to team members. So if we want people to be able to ask more robust questions on that AI setting, we can say fields from any fields from source, right? Which allows us to open it up so that the AI can use data from not only the fields in the block, but from any fields. All right. So let's shut the this down. Oh, we also have instructions and personality and response style that we can update if we don't like the defaults. And then we've got suggested prompts, let AI suggest. And this can be helpful if people don't really know how to use AI, or if you want to encourage them to start using AI more, have some prompts pop up there for them. So when they open up the AI module or modal, they are going to see some questions that they might get started with. And then lastly, appearance. We get the AI avatar. We can toggle that on or off if we don't want it. We've got the original or round style. We can choose to use the avatar or not. We get the message bubbles, modern, round, or sharp in terms of style. So a lot of flexibility in how this presents. But let's go ahead and publish our app and take it out for a spin. So I'm going to go ahead and open it up. I'm not going to actually access the app right now. Let's preview the app, though, and get rolling with it. So here I am, presumably, in the app. I'm in my projects section, right? I've got all my different project data here. You can see how many budgeted hours, how many hours have been spent, the status of the different projects, etc. We can add records. Cool. Okay. Add new project, but what we're here for, it's all about that AI. So let's ask AI and see what happens. Pops open the modal, a sliding bar from the side, and here's the icon, here's the initial prompt, how can I help you, and here are some suggested options. So let's go. Which projects are currently at risk? Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and just kind of wait and see where this goes. Also, by the way, notice that I'm logged in. I'm impersonating Ava at Hydra Fit right here. So that's why I'm showing up right here. But just like that, I mean, we're interacting with the AI directly here. We're getting insights into our existing data. This has summarized the different projects that we have that are at risk, what we might think about them, different things. I want to say, what's the overall health of our project pipeline right now? Let's say in progress. And let's see how it analyzes this. I mean, I haven't used this AI a ton, but this is pretty good stuff. Here's an overview of your current project pipeline. So, I mean, I am really enjoying enabling AI inside of our apps. I mean, it makes our teams more efficient. It's like adding a new team member for a fraction of the cost, because now we have all of the things that we might have taken us hours to kind of compile, all kinds of data analysis that we might need to do. And now we can just have those conversations with a machine directly in our apps and get feedback in real time. So really powerful stuff available now, and you can choose where you're bringing that AI in. Do you want it on all the pages in your app? Do you want it on calendar, team, and tasks? Or do you just care about having AI at the project level? You can choose where people are able to access it. You can choose what different data the bot or the AI tool has access to grant in its responses. You can choose so much about it, customize how it shows up, and this is really taking your Softr apps yet again to the next level. I know we went quickly in this video. There's a lot to cover with this new feature, but I hope you got a ton of value from this. If you have questions that we did not answer here, or if you're looking for some more advanced help, swing by our website. We have a ton of resources available and people on call available to meet with you and help you put this into your no-code apps. Of course, if you got value from the video, we'd love a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, but most importantly, my friends, keep on building.